Bitcoin hot fork. So all blockchains, including Bitcoin, are software. There may be errors that's not acknowledged yet, or not confirmed, not yet manifested, or unverified. And there are a lot of complaints about the slow processing speed of Bitcoin. So in the past, there were a lot of suggestions for the better speed of the Bitcoin. Among the countless proposals to grow both Bitcoin in 2017, two big updates. One that wanted to update Bitcoin called SegWit, and the one that had different direction called Bitcoin Unlimited collided. As a result of the crash, Bitcoin Unlimited split the change into something called Bitcoin Cash. This was one of the biggest events in the Bitcoin history. When the move occurred, the market was very unstable because nobody knew, and nobody actually could guess what would happen to the market by this split decision. So this will actually result in the price fell of the Bitcoin. However, after taking it apart, they recognized soon that this was not a bad decision. Everything went well because there was no problem. Whether this large event had led to an increase in Bitcoin price, and the media focused and draws attention. In this case, decision was made in form of splitting the change. Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash came out when it was decided, we have different opinions, so we'll go our separate ways. After that, several projects split off for similar reasons or various other reasons. The separation of one change into two is called hard fork. A hard fork is named after a chain that was once divided into several branches like a fork. In the case of Ethereum, it's a very famous incident. They worked in a project called DAO, and a large-scale hacking took place at the moment. The DAO is an organization established in 2016 by Vitalik Buterin, the founder of Ethereum, with the aim of creating a company that operates without a board of directors or owner. The majors were able to prevent the withdrawal of stolen Ethereum, but the amount of the virtual assets attacked is said to be about $43 million. Vitalik Buterin suggests to a hard fork since Ethereum's damage was so great. So he has to turn back the data into the position before the accident happened. And it actually served as an opportunity for Ethereum to emerge. Hard fork was adapted as a countermeasure to the DAO hacking incident. And about 90% of the node operators decide and agree to the hard forking. The remaining 10% believe that the hard fork violates the original purpose of the blockchain of a decentralization. And the Ethereum chain was separated without updating the node. That's why Ethereum and Ethereum Classics were separated. Due to fierce confrontation, the community was separated and project was split. Through this series of events, everyone thought a decision-making structure is needed in operating a blockchain network. There were doubts about whether it would be sustainable if you split or fight such inconsistent interest happens every time. Therefore, recognition that a decision-making structure called governance is essential and necessary for decision-making in blockchain projects. The first project to raise awareness of the problem was Tezos. And Tezos first expressed his position in 2014 and formalized that there should be a governance structure. So Tezos is still taking a very fundamental approach to solving the problem when it comes to the governance structure. In case of making MakerDAO, a DeFi project, MakerDAO is a project that allows holders to operate in a structure where they can make their own decisions and the overall decisions. The community continues to suggest, let's do this marketing, and let's put this function in, and let's change this policy. These various proposals came out and are registered on the ballot agenda, and if the vote exceeds the threshold, the policy is implemented. Token holders determine important issues in fairly democratic way. DAO is a decentralized autonomous organization. It has decentralized autonomous organization as a philosophy and has structures that explicitly make decisions through the act of voting or something similar to it. A lot of projects, this method is to create a governance structure, proceed with the project. That doesn't mean it applies to everyone because there are technical problems and I'll explain them in more detail later. However, projects that want to build truly decentralized communities are adopting this voting structure. Before moving on to the next content, let's first move on to what's the meaning of the blockchain governance. According to the research Blockchain Governance, written by Aaron Fisher and Maria Cruz Valiente, they define the blockchain governance as: blockchain governance can be regarded as integration of norms and culture and the laws and the code, the people and the institutions that facilitate coordination and together determine a given organization.
포토콘이 궁금하다면 좋아요, 구독, 알림 설정까지.